My name is Diane Hopster, and I'm a hydrologist for the Columbia River Gorge National Scenic Area and the Mount Hood National Forest. I also worked as a hydrologist on the Burn Area Emergency Response Team, or the BEAR team. A BEAR team is a team that gets together with a lot of different disciplines like engineering, hydrology, wildlife biology, fisheries biology, soil scientists. And they get together and they assess the fire after it's mostly out to look at what kind of emergency response activities need to be implemented. And a lot of it is focused on reducing erosion and preventing any major landslides or debris flows. Post-fire erosion is determined by a combination of climate, topography, including slope, surface rock armoring, needle cast or litter fall, and fire severity. The Eagle Creek fire area has two kind of distinct soil types that we see. There's the very rocky talus slope terrain, and then there's these more well-developed soils. In the rocky talus slope, we have a lot of surface rock armoring, which actually helps reduce erosion, though pre-fire, a lot of these slopes were covered in moss that kind of held the rock together. And then after the fire in the high burn severity areas on these talus slopes, that moss burned away. So it did result in oversteepened slopes, and we did see localized rock sliding, and we may continue to see that until the moss regrows. In the well-developed soil areas, we're actually finding some natural revegetation of native plants, as well as some fungal mats that are kind of binding the soil together. Due to the very steep terrain and the inaccessibility of most of the Eagle Creek fire area, and that is in part due to the fact that most of the fire area was in wilderness, it's difficult to do a lot of the erosion controls that we would probably do on areas with a lot more roads that's more accessible and not in wilderness areas. As far as the very steep terrain, it can cause safety issues, trees falling, hazard trees, things like that. So we don't like to put people in that situation. Lucky for us, we have a very resilient landscape in the Eagle Creek fire area. We're already seeing a lot of natural revegetation, as well as after the burn, there's a lot of litter fall and debris. You can see that there's needle cast, as well as burned trees that fall over, and they add roughness, which actually helps to create like a natural mulch and reduce erosion itself. Some of the recommendations that the BEAR team made for reducing post-fire erosion on the Eagle Creek fire included improving drainage on the few roads within the Eagle Creek fire area. And by improving drainage, because roads intercept surface flow, they tend to concentrate flow and then it will create landslides or debris flows. And so by improving the drainage, you're spreading the flow out and keeping it from concentrating and resulting in erosion that could go downslope and into stream channels and affect fisheries down below. There were also a lot of recommendations within the Multnomah Falls area that gets a lot of people from all over the world. It's really important that rock fall is prevented that either damage the historic structure there, the Multnomah Falls Lodge, and then also protect the people that are there to look at the waterfall. The recommendations at the Multnomah Falls site included what you could call geotextiles. They're basically rock catchment fencing that when rocks do fall down the steep slopes that have burned, it's going to stop those, and then they actually have to be cleaned out on a regular basis. A good example of a steep slope that we see in the Eagle Creek fire area. It's not really a safe place to go and try to plant anything. But you can see that the fire burns like in these mosaics, so that vegetation that didn't burn can then spread to the areas where it did burn, and that helps with revegetation as well. Erosion can be a very natural process. For example, when we have fine sediments erode down the slope and into the stream, they deposit in floodplains and then are quickly colonized by vegetation, native vegetation like willows and cottonwoods and things like that, that actually stabilize the channel. So fine sediments can be a very good thing, and natural processes can affect and improve water quality sometimes. When erosion is caused by non-natural processes is when we get more than the system can handle, and that's why we focus some of our recommendations on things like the roads, where it's unnaturally concentrating flows that could then erode downslope and add more sediment than the system can necessarily handle. Right now we look at the landscape and we see a lot of black charred soils, not a lot of vegetation, but ultimately in the spring, we'll probably start seeing a lot of little green sprouts coming on this hill slope. Vegetation that can handle this type of environment will start growing, and then ultimately, once it has established, then new vegetation will move in, and ultimately we'll end up with the native vegetation and the type of forested environment we had before the fire. And the ecosystem here is able to basically regenerate itself. It knows better than we do how to get back to the state it was in prior to the fire.